What's that thing they say about history? About those who don't learn from it?
The Metropolitan Transportation Authority is expected to find immediate solutions to problems that should have been faced over the last 35 years.
But by 1973, the five-year-old MTA was patting itself on the back about a series of shiny new expansion projects, like the Second Avenue subway. Meanwhile, deferred maintenance, which is exactly what it sounds like, had the system crumbling so badly that New Yorkers began to flee.
I think they're lousy.
Flee at a rate that, if it kept up, would leave no one riding the subways by the early 2000s.
Our politicians have amnesia. They don't remember. They don't follow history.
Sam Schwartz spent those decades as a city transportation engineer.
Starving a system, thinking you're saving money, is going to cause a lot of headaches down the road.
Out of that crisis came the first of many capital plans. Mitchell Moss runs the Transportation Center at NYU.
New York, under Governor Carey and then Governor Mario Cuomo, invested about $70 billion, and the subway system went from a point where we had 3 million riders a day to 6 million riders a day very successfully.
So there's just a touch of irony in the MTA's go-to explanation for what causes the most subway delays, which are up 150% in less than 5 years.
Those are things that fail when you have a capacity problem, and we are at capacity.
Of course, overcrowding wouldn't be such a problem if we'd invested in a modern signal system that could run more trains closer together. So why don't we do that now?
And they're talking 7 years per line, 40 years to put a new signal system in the subway. I mean, forget it.
More on that next week. But here's the point.
The true failures started during the Pataki and Spitz administration when they went for East Side Access and Second Avenue subway rather than investing in modernization and maintaining a good system. The priority should be taking care of what we have, because that's what moving 6 million people a day.
6 million frustrated people.
It took me 2 hours to make a 45-minute commute the other day.
One day, I was 2 hours and 40 minutes late to work.
Today, people regularly get on the train not knowing if they'll ever get to work.
John Raskin heads the Riders Alliance, an advocacy group.
That's unacceptable for the city.
We have to have an MTA recognizes that this is a crisis which requires crisis management, not business as usual.
Seems like we're getting there.
Declaring a state of emergency.
Or are we?
For anyone to say, not my problem, it's the state's problem, they don't know the law. They don't know the history.
I hope that our elected officials move a lot faster than waiting until we have casualties on our transit system.
Till next time, safe travels. I'm Alex Silverman, and this is The Breaking Point.